The Man Without Fear. Are you ready to watch me put on the suit and do a full costume reveal? Let's go. I'm so excited for today's video because I'm displaying my brand new Man Without Fear Daredevil cosplay. Let's get this video started. All right, there's so many reasons why I love the character Daredevil as I begin to put this costume on. First and foremost, if you're seeing this, I am wearing the Daredevil Netflix series costume right here. I have a couple variations that you'll see as I begin to put this thing on, but it was one of the reasons that I love the character so much, but it wasn't my first love for the character. Actually, back in 2001, Brian Bendis and Alex Maleev wrote on the Man Without Fear Daredevil series for 4 years. And in this series, they went over a bunch of challenging issues. The most being Daredevil getting his secret identity exposed to the entire world. Now, this series had just some of the most insanely beautiful art, and the storytelling was just unlike anything I had ever experienced. And after reading all the issues, I was like, well, I need to get a deeper understanding and development for the character. So I actually hopped in with Frank Miller's Born Again, which is one of the most praised graphic novels of our entire generation. Definitely something I'd recommend checking out. It's very beautifully written. There's a bunch of other books. One thing I always loved about Daredevil is he always had very talented artists and writers writing on him and really just developing these amazing stories. Now, Daredevil originally had a change of character once Frank Miller took over the writing back in the 80s. Before, he had, you know, been like most other Marvel characters, pretty lively, fun, you know, not a lot of darkness behind him. But as soon as Frank Miller took over the series got a lot darker, and in turn, he gained a pretty cult-like fan base. So now we're gonna actually put this piece on right here. Cool for me, I can just put it on myself. Most of my other cosplays is kind of hard for me to do, especially these bulky suits. This one is a lot easier. Still, this part is definitely the most challenging because it is a little bit tight and this stuff likes to stick together. Before we get back into, you know, my love for the comics, we're gonna zip this bad boy up right here. And this suit is actually the screen print version of the White Sheep leather. Definitely an amazingly done suit, honestly one of my favorites. For me, I made a couple variations to make it more screen accurate, I guess you could say, because it's not a movie accurate. And what I did was I actually had these created. Somebody 3D printed these. I actually painted them myself and then went in and added the weathering look to them to make it look like, you know, I'd worn them out. Again, just buckling these two little buckles right here. And then these were black, and I actually painted them myself to kind of have that silver look. It definitely adds a lot to the costume itself. And for the suit itself, it came kind of loose. So I actually had to get this bad boy tailored so that we had that tight fitting arms, because one of the biggest issues is, like, you know, you don't want to be the loose hero, you know, with your everything all loose right here. You want to have that nice fitted look, you know, and Daredevil definitely had that in the Netflix series. Let's move on to the next piece that I have for you guys today. We have the Daredevil billy clubs with the billy club holder right here. And again, I put it on wrong last time I did, so we're gonna fix that this time. They have this little groove right here that allows them to just stick right in there. And then we have the longer one, and that just goes right in there. And then the cool thing about these were custom made as well, is we actually have the double D on each placement here. Now, I'm just going to go ahead, and these straps are actually just Velcro, so it makes it really easy for me to just do this myself, put that bad boy on. And while we're here, let's get started in talking about the Netflix series. So I was so excited when I heard that Netflix was actually going to be releasing a series on DD. Sorry, this takes me a second. And man, I will tell you, I was not disappointed. Now, the only issue I had with the series was the story development was amazing. The characters were super well portrayed. All the actors did an excellent job. I was just so disappointed that we didn't get to see the Daredevil suit up until the very last episode of season one. Now, season two for me will go down in the books as probably one of my favorite TV series of all time. We got to see our introduction to Frank Castle, Elektra. The Hand was a real big play in this series, and it was just amazing. Just seeing the development between Punisher and Daredevil was awesome, and it was actually based off of a Punisher issue, if you guys remember, where Daredevil gets tied up, where, you know, he actually does that to him in the comics, and I actually own this series, so I was really geeking out when that came out. So let's get started with the next piece of our costume, and that is none other than these amazing gloves that he brought out in season two. After Daredevil shot him in the cowl, he had a couple costume changes. So in season one, he originally had these black gloves with the black faced Daredevil mask, and he ended up having these like shoulder guards right here to kind of like, I guess, deflect armor and whatnot. And he actually got rid of that in season two and moved to a more classic look for the design for the character, which I was way more a fan of. I definitely love that helmet. And although I don't have it today, I'm still waiting on it. I'll show you my custom one here in a moment. So these were some custom gloves that I bought, and these were the gloves that they came with. As you can see, there's a big difference. These ones still look all right, but as soon as you put these ones up next to them, it's no competition, you know? And these are still really easy to put on, but before I put these bad boys on, it's really hard for me to put this thing on and with the gloves on, so I figured I'd do this next. This is just a hood, it's a texturized hood that I'm just gonna put on. Now, you gotta make sure that this thing is lined up and it's nice and tucked in, because it does kind of come out. Still trying to figure out what I'm gonna do, maybe adding some Velcro to it to let it work its way out just a little bit better. I look like Daredevil at night right now. And this beautiful helmet. Oh man, look at this thing. I'll give you guys another close up of this. Got the carbon fiber on the sides. Man, this is what Daredevil looks like. Yes. And I really love this helmet variation compared to the Netflix series, because the Netflix series kind of gave him more of the Batman nose guard, where it kind of came all the way down. And this one really sticks true to the comic roots, has a nice pointy ears. And you know, I like that you can see a lot more of the nose. And I actually decided to shave. I know in Daredevil in the Netflix series, he has facial hair, but I feel like this is definitely more of a classic look. So I decided to, you know, have the just OG Daredevil. And I was extremely happy whenever this helmet came in, because it just fits like a glove. It really fits perfectly. So for these, it's just a Velcro piece. This is actually, if you can tell, it's like a rubber, which is kind of nice. And then same with this, is like a, it's like a hard texture, and then these are rubber as well. So I'm just gonna put this bad boy on. I'm blind, remember, so I can't tell sometimes with the hands. That's why I almost put it on the wrong hand. Okay, give me a sec. Really wanna make sure that glove is tucked in right here. And this part is kind of difficult right here a little bit, but I can always make it work. We want that bad boy nice and snug. Oh, there we go. We're in business. And for the next place, and I really, really love this costume, because it's really easy to put on and it doesn't take a whole lot of time. Now, it is pretty hot up in here, but you know, sometimes you just gotta make do with what you got. Ooh, and there you have it. Here is my Daredevil costume, the Devil of Hell's Kitchen. Let me pull out the baton so you can see these. And these are really, really cool. I didn't get to show you this other side. So if you can hear that clicking, that is because these actually come together. So give me just a second. Now, I'll be honest, the issue I have with these gloves is they're a lot thicker than the other ones, so it's harder for me to do stuff like this. But once you get it started, you're in business. And then he has like the longer club that we see him use sometimes in the series. And these are pretty sturdy actually. And then look at what else I can do with this. So that little clicking noise that you hear right here. Hey, well, it looks like I went on the wrong side. So let me just, give me just a second. I'm gonna restart this for you real quick. This should be the right side, hopefully. And then you have the wire that he has in the series as well. Super cool design. Something so simple, but it like just adds so much to the cosplay, in my own opinion. All right, let's go get a better look of and a closer look of this costume. I become the blind lawyer, vigilante by night, the man without fear, the one, the only, the daredevil. If you guys enjoyed the vibe of this video, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe to the page. Your support here is awesome, and you are part of the family. Hey, we got tons of nerd content coming for you guys, so be on the lookout. New videos every Friday. So if you enjoyed this, again, like, comment, and share with your friends. It'd mean the world to me, and I am out. I'll see you next time.